Good morning, good morning, beautiful people. It is your boy Shannon Coleman Sr., aka The Rev, and it is Saturday morning. And you know, I did a little workout, got some blood work back. You know, that A1C is still in that pre-diabetic range, trying to get some more of this weight off. You know, because it keeps fluctuating, going back and forth. But hey, that's neither here nor there. Today I want to talk to you about, you know, evaluating self and not allowing people to make you feel bad about who you are. See, sometimes people will try to use you up. You know, they just want to get what they can get from you, and always taking and giving a little bit so that they can just, they can constantly, you know, hold that little bit that they do over your head when you don't give them what it is that they want or that they're asking for, right? They tend to try to throw that thing up in your face so that they can try to make you feel bad because you told them no. You know, when you're around people that you're constantly giving to, that you're constantly feeding in, that you're constantly giving. And then that one time out of 100, or maybe even two, even if it's 3 times out of 100, that you tell them no or you can't do, and they give you their behind to kiss, and they start going off on you and telling you how much you never do for them or how much you never did for them, then it's time for you to tell them, you know what, we need to take a break. We need to take a break until you can recognize and see all that I do for you, because I don't throw it up in your face. You throw that little thing up in, if they throw that little thing up in your face that they do, and you constantly give, and you don't throw nothing up in their face, and you don't even really ask them for anything, but you tell them no, 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 or 5 times out of 100, and they can't accept that no, it's time for you to reevaluate that situation. It's time for you to reevaluate that relationship. It's time for you to really sit that person down and tell them, listen, if you cannot appreciate what it is that I do for you, if you cannot appreciate how much I did or do sacrifice for you, then maybe it's time for us to take a break so that you can see just how much I do. It's okay to say no. And don't let anybody make you feel bad about saying no. Because if they understood, if they loved you, if they cared about you, and if they respected you, they will understand that your no was a no that was needed in that time. Especially when most of the time you say yes. Especially when most of the time you give. Even if you're giving in the shadows and they don't know what you did because you don't speak about what you did. And then they come to you directly, but you tell them, I can't do that. I can't let you borrow that money right now. And I got some bills to pay. I can't come pick you up right now because I have things that I need to take care of. You know, so no, I'm not going to be able to pick you up. You know what I mean? I can't, you know, do whatever it is that you're asking me to do in this moment. You know what I mean? But, you know, I apologize for that. I hope, you know, all is well. And they can't accept that? It's not you. It's not you. So don't get depressed. Don't get full of anxiety. Don't get full of rage. Don't do none of that. Evaluate the relationship and move in that relationship accordingly. Even if you got to start saying no 99 times out of 100 and yes once, then they'll see how many yeses they received. Even if you got to start pulling back out of the shadows, what you give in the shadows, so that they can know that, dag, they were working in the shadow. They were working, they were giving, and I didn't even know because they never even spoke on it. So that way, that person will begin, or those people will begin to love, respect, and cherish the things that you do. You don't got to throw it up in their face and tell them what you do for them. Nah, don't do that. Just pull back. And then they'll figure it out on their own. I love you all with the love of God. Ain't nothing you could do about it. You can do all things through Christ that gives you strength. And never forget, I am my brother's keeper. And I'm also my sister's protector. Peace.